first. High, high, high. Look down, look, that's it, that's it, that's it, that's it.
Hey, it's Magic here, and I'm here to elevate your perspective. FPV drones aren't just thrilling to fly.
This week, a new study found graduates with degrees in science, technology, engineering, and math ended up in careers with higher salaries and lower unemployment. And right now, STEM students across the country...
Building and flying these drones teaches everything from problem solving to hands-on work with electronics, and it's an exciting way to learn skills that can land jobs in cutting-edge industries. Yet, there's still a significant gap in who's taking advantage of this. I recently checked my YouTube analytics and found that over 99% of my audience is male. That got me thinking, why aren't more females involved in tech hobbies like FPV drones? According to figures from the National Center for Biotechnology Information, the NCBI, men outnumber women in engineering employment at a ratio of nearly 9 to 1, even though men and women are represented approximately equally in the population. That's a staggering disparity and highlights how underrepresented women are in fields like engineering and technology. This gap isn't just about numbers, it's about missed opportunity for so many talented girls and young women. That's why today's video is so important. I'm here to show that girls like Taylor can be just as passionate and capable when it comes to building and flying drones. In this field, there's an enormous opportunity for young girls to learn hands-on skills like soldering, understanding microelectronics, and developing the discipline and focus it takes to fly. These aren't just hobbies. They're gateways to careers in engineering, technology, and science. By encouraging our daughters to explore these fields early on, we can bridge the gender gap in tech and inspire the next generation of innovators.
What is all this stuff, Daddy?
All right, Tay, you're gonna be flying like a professional. I'm gonna teach you to be a professional. We're gonna teach you to fly one of these. This is called a cine whoop. See this thing over here? Ultimately, this is the one I want you to fly. This is called a 5-inch racing helmet. You think you can do it?
Yeah.
You sure?
I can just chop off.
You think it'll hurt if...
I think I could just chop off a couple heads.
Oh, yeah. Okay, we gotta be really careful with that one.
This is my daughter, Taylor. At 13, she's diving into a new adventure, flying FPV drones. Taylor is always eager to try something new, and she bursts with creativity. Whether she's cooking up something delicious, sketching, painting, or crafting something, she's always got a project going. And to top it off, she's one of the most generous people you'll meet. She'd spend her birthday money on gifts for everyone else. Of course, she's always on the lookout for a good sale while she's at it. But when she runs out of projects and gets bored, oh, that's when we're really in for it. We love this girl. Back to flying drones. Taylor is young. And it's her eagerness to constantly try new things, part of her boundless energy and curiosity, that I believe will help her succeed. Flying FPV drones takes discipline, but if you're too afraid to push boundaries, you'll never learn or improve. Since this is her first time flying, I'm walking her through the basics of what makes an FPV quad unique and helping her understand some key terminology. So what do we mean by throttle, yaw, pitch, and roll? These are the basic controls that let a drone move in any direction. Throttle adjusts the power to the motors, making the drone move faster in the direction it's pointed. Yaw is what makes the drone rotate left or right on its vertical axis. Imagine turning your head left or right. Pitch tilts the drone forward or backward, controlling how you move ahead or pull back. Finally, roll allows the drone to tilt side to side, which helps with banking turns. When you're flying FPV, understanding how these controls interact in the air is key to maintaining control and pulling off smooth moves. As a new pilot, you need to digest how the drone's orientation changes mid-flight and how to adjust based on its position and momentum. Mastering this balance is what makes flying FPV so rewarding. To help Taylor get comfortable with these controls, we've started her on a simulator called Velocidrone. Velocidrone is renowned among FPV pilots for its accurate physics more than its graphics, making it one of the best tools for learning how drones actually behave in the air. In the sim, she can crash as many times as she needs to without worrying about damaging expensive gear or, more importantly, hurting anyone. It's the perfect safe space to learn how to fly. The goal is to help her progress from the simulator to flying a small cine-whoop in a real field.
I have a little knob here, and the more I push it, the faster it allows you to go. So I don't want you to go too fast and kill somebody. All I want you to do is raise the throttle and go in the air. You got it? Raise the throttle, and I just want to win the test. Go ahead. Go. Grab you. Yeah!
You can just raise the throttle!
You just killed 5 people!
And eventually, she'll move on to a larger drone as her skills develop. This way, she'll build confidence and precision every step of the way.
Are you landing okay? Yes, yes, you got it. So Zoe, I'm gonna show you how to cut a pancake. You don't need forks.
You need to wash your hands at least.
Yeah.
My hands are washed.
How do you think your sister's gonna do today, flying for the first time?
Taylor, don't overeat. Rain or shine, in this family, baby, we just fly. We fly. We don't care if it rains. We don't care if there's lightning.
What do you think? Is this a good day? Is the weather a great day for droning today?
Right,
kind of settle down. Let's see if we don't fly it into a puddle. Take
so
a closer
tiny.
Look. So tiny? Yeah, but it's gonna fly pretty fast. What was your question about the antenna?
Do I put it up?
She's asking a great question. Antenna orientation is really important. Typically, for dipole antennas like these, you would want the antenna on your RC controller to match the angle of the antenna on your drone. Think of the signal spreading out like a donut where the tip of the antenna pokes through the center. The strongest part of the signal is in the ring of the donut, extending many feet or even miles out. The center of the donut, right where the antenna tip is, has the weakest signal. So, to ensure a strong connection, you would want the rings of your signal donut to align between your controller and your drone. All right, turn your controller on.
Switch warning.
Switch warning. So you have to clear the switches the way.
When powering up an RC radio with pots and switches, it performs a safety check before sending signals to the drone. A key part of this is ensuring that the arming switch is off and the throttle is fully down. Without this, the drone could take off unexpectedly, posing a safety risk. Taylor is guided by the radio to confirm that everything is in the correct default position.
And
that's nice and tight. And is it in the center?
Yeah.
That's important too. We want it to be in the center so the center of gravity is correct and it doesn't start wobbling. Ready? Okay, here we go. Here we go. I'm gonna take off. And then I'm gonna let you take control. You ready? I'm gonna go a little bit higher.
Throttle control is one of the hardest things to master in acro mode as a beginner, especially with a cine-whoop.
You gotta bring that throttle up when I pass control, you ready?
If the throttle stick is too low, the cine-whoop will descend quickly, often feeling delayed, which can cause overshooting and a crash landing. Too high, and it shoots up rapidly. It's like docking a boat where you're constantly adjusting for acceleration and deceleration. Finding that balance takes time.
Ready, and you're in control. Pitch forward, there you go, that's it. You're going too high. There you go. Nice. I'm not taking over, go. There you go, you got it, pretty good. You got control, there you go. Nice, Tay, keep going in that direction, that's really good. Keep going.
This here is another common mistake new pilots often make.
Nice.
As you roll an FPV quad past a certain angle, it stops generating enough lift to keep itself in the air.
You were you're rolling too much to the left. Remember what we talked about? If you roll too much to the left, what happens? It'll just fall.
You just fall.
So how do you
we can get caught up in the excitement of having full control over the quad's direction and attitude, but it's easy to forget that gravity is always in play. Once you roll past that critical threshold, you either have to commit to fully completing the roll and returning to a level position, or pulling back in the opposite direction to quickly re-level your aircraft.
Okay, here we go. And you're in control.
I was thoroughly impressed by her first flight.
Very good, very good.
She maintained remarkably steady control of the drone, even in Acro mode, which is no small feat, especially for someone so young. Taylor did so well, it was time to step her up to a real freestyle Acro drone. The tried and true FPV quad. These drones are incredibly agile, and if you've watched my first video, you've seen just how amazing their performance can be. That's why it's crucial that we're flying in a wide, open field, away from people, with all safety precautions in place. These quads can be a blast, but making sure safety is a priority is always the first step.
Here we go.
Oh, three.
You're in control. You're in control. Go.
76.
Go. You're in control. You slow down.
76.
Okay. It's okay. Pay attention. Pay attention. Start turning. Nice. 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 Nice.
Taylor is moving on to more complex maneuvers now that she's mastered low altitude flight. Here, she's pulling off a snap roll. If you've never flown before, it might look simple, but it's anything but. To perform a snap roll, you quickly lower the throttle, letting gravity take over, then snap the roll stick to one side. As soon as the quad levels out, within less than a second, you have to quickly raise the throttle, just enough to stay in control without climbing or falling. Here it is in another form, otherwise known as a snap flip. She was doing great, so I handed her the iFlight Chimera 7, an incredibly powerful and capable drone. While 7-inch quads are amazing for their stability and range, perfect for long-range flights and stunning mountain dives, they're not something I'd recommend as a first drone. These drones require careful control and experience due to their power and precision.
Going up, 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 up. Now look down, look down. Do it. Turn, 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 turn.
Sure, there are other young pilots out there, but as a dad, watching her make this breakthrough is a special thrill. For any parents out there, you can probably relate. It's like that classic moment when we let go of the backseat of our child's new two-wheel bike and watch the excitement on their face as they keep their balance for the first time.
I'm wondering if you want to learn to fly a drone today.
More importantly, as a father, I'm connecting with my daughter. And that is more magical than flight. It's truly remarkable to see Taylor, at just 13 years old, achieve this level of control over an FPV drone. This hobby isn't just fun. It's a great way to introduce young people, especially talented young girls, to the world of building, working with small electronics, and applying technical skills in a hands-on way. There's a whole world of opportunity here, and we should encourage more young girls to dive in and explore. Try watching your child soar, and it'll be nothing short of magical.
Go forward!
Oh, and I almost forgot. You're probably wondering what happened with that dive Taylor was making at the beginning of the video. This is how that played out.
First, hi. Look down, look, that's it. Look down. I thought you were going to do the roll.
Oh,
she did just fine. I was just messing with you. Do me a favor and share this video with a special lady in your life. Your sister, your mom, daughter, anyone who could be inspired by FPV. If you have enjoyed this video, like and subscribe. And don't forget to drop a comment. I'd love to hear your thoughts or experiences with drones or technology. Let's keep this conversation going.